Morning everyone, it's Nicole from the Physio Crew. Now I know that this is a question that so many people ask me in clinic and it's going to be very, very popular for you guys at home, in pain, unsure what to do. So when you are injured, it can be really, really difficult, not just physically, but emotionally as well. So particularly if you're active, if you perceive yourself as being an active person, you can't get that social support of being going out and running with the group. You're not necessarily feeling good about yourself because you use running to have that nice boost of serotonin. You also may feel like you're getting overweight or you just don't feel as good. We know that exercise often makes people feel really, really good and energized. And so being away from that can be really, really difficult. So if you've had pain for more than kind of 2 weeks, it depends on the pain as well. You might be getting neck pain, you might be getting shoulder pain, you might be getting back pain or ankle pain. Perhaps you had an ankle sprain, perhaps you ruptured your Achilles, perhaps you had a fracture. It can be really, really frustrating to feel like you're on your own. So one of the things that you need to think about is what area of my body is injured. When I was working with the Bristol Ladies Premiership side, I looked after 12 international players. None of them, even when they were really badly injured, apart from concussion, we weren't able to do anything with them. Physios are experts in being able to work out what you can do even when you're injured. So just because you have a shoulder problem doesn't mean that you can't be doing stuff on your lower body. So you could be doing things like cycling. This video is for information purposes only. I can't speak about individuals because I don't know your past medical history, I don't know your circumstances, so make sure that you're booking in for a discovery call if you're not sure. But you want to be thinking, right, it's my knee that's the issue, so how's my other knee doing? Is it something that would be affected if I was on the anti-gravity treadmill or if I was in a swimming pool? Sometimes it's just taking the weight off that's important. I had a guy last week who I've been treating for whiplash who's been getting some ongoing back problems, and we've been doing a little bit of massage, bit of soft tissue work, and he was feeling like it was getting really, really great after the treatment, but 3 or 4 days later it would come back. One of the things that was happening is because he had a lot of pain, he was guarding through the movement, so he wasn't able to move properly. That wasn't his fault, that was his brain giving him a signal saying don't move and try and protect, but that was making his pain worse. So we got him on the Alter G, we took off about 30% of his body weight, and I actually just got him running. So the pain was still like a 1 or 2 out of 10, but we just got him moving, and then when he actually got off the Alter G, he could move freely. A lot of people are obsessed with, I mean, we still do acupuncture, soft tissue mobilizations, massage, but it's not always the right thing. Sometimes what we actually need to do is get people moving and get them strong. But you know, if you've got a lot of pain, we can do those things in the beginning and then get you on the Alter G or get you in the hydro pool so that you can move more normally. Other things that you can do, if for example you thought, well, I can't really afford to come in for the Alter G, I can't afford to have hydro, then what you need to think about is what things can you be doing. So for example, looking and educating yourself on the recent evidence, things like meniscal problems, knee problems can be very, very good if you have if you're cycling, for example. So they did a study based on rats. Now we're not rats, so you have to be a little bit careful about how you extrapolate the results, but they got them, they gave them meniscal issues, which is not very nice, and cartilage tears, and then they got them moving on a pre-made bike, which is a pretty mean study. But what they did find is that with these cartilage tears, they responded well to 20 minutes of cycling every single day over the course of the study period. So there's lots of things that we can do cardiovascular wise. If you're not sure what you're able to do, then why not try and get a little bit of help to push you along your way. Anyway, hashtag useful. If it's been useful, please tag anybody who's got pain who may benefit from this little bit of motivation this morning to get them moving again. And of course, if you're unsure, then book in for your discovery call. It's completely free, 30 minutes, and it will just let us help you know where you are and whether there's anything we might be able to do to help. Take care. Bye-bye.